We are going to celebrate the Independence Day 2021. So over to Achal. Achal, please start.
Ask not what your country can do for you, ask what you can do for your country. Good morning, everyone. I, Anshul Sharma, welcome you all to the 75th Independence Day. The Independence Day of India, which is celebrated religiously throughout the country on the 15th August every year, holds tremendous ground in the list of national days, since it reminds every Indian about the dawn of a new beginning, the beginning of deliverance from the clutches of colonialism of more than 200 years. This year, the theme of Independence Day is Nation First, Always First, to honor the sacrifices made by our freedom fighters and the glorious path laid down for generations by them. It is true that a prayer that comes from the heart can move mountains. It increases your faith and brings you closer to God. So let's start our event by a prayer by Mr. Pahulpreet Singh, who is assistant professor in the School of IT.
आदरणीय डायरेक्टर सर, स्मूथ अध्यापक और प्यारे विद्यार्थी, आप सबको नमस्कार और स्वतंत्रता दिवस की हार्दिक शुभकामनाएं. आए सब मिलके गाएं.
Thank you.
So I must say, it was a very beautiful performance. Now, I request our worthy director, sir, Dr. Rajesh Bagga, to address the audience.
Good morning, everyone. So first of all, I must congratulate all of you on the occasion of 75th. Independence Day of the country. My dear friends, my colleagues, dear students, nation celebrated 75th Independence Day of the country yesterday, and this celebration, it is in continuation with the previous day celebrations. And I am really glad to share, yesterday our faculty members, they visited the campus. The flag hoisting ceremony took place, and we celebrated 75th Independence Day with full zeal and enthusiasm. So definitely now I would request all the deans, from next year onwards, we will be on campus activity. Definitely this is because of the COVID pandemic time period. We are celebrating like this on virtual mode, but in a selective way. Yesterday, the flag hoisting ceremony took place in our campus. And to start with, first of all, I would like to naman all the martyrs and the countrymen, those laid their sacrifices and their lives for the sake of country. And I think all will recite Jai Hind, Jai Bharat three times along with me by unmuting themselves. Jai Hind. Yes.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Hind.
Jai Bharat.
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 So, dear friends, yesterday when the celebration took place, we were discussing. All countrymen, they should go by the speech of Prime Minister, but the Prime Minister of the country every year. Reason being, I just discussed yesterday, from last 15 years, I'm going through all the speeches of all the Prime Ministers, whosoever the party was. Reason being, why I'm emphasizing all this, reason being, whenever the Independence Day speech delivered from the Lal Qila, it is about the whole year. It is the all the activities, all the policies, all the strategies which the government of India, they are doing it. And all these are summarized in such a way that all they must be in a position to understand how, as a nation, we are progressing at a global front. So yesterday, I think the new slogan this time, it was given, nation first, always first. It is wonderful. And I think we should appreciate this. And along with this, in yesterday's speech, the major one takeaway, it was Sabka Saath, Sabka Vishwas, Sabka Vikas. And in last one, what was added? It is Sabka Prayas. So what is it? Sabka Prayas means now it is turn of all the youth brigade of the country to come forward and do a lot of hard work with lot of sincerity, devotion, dedication, and loyalty, so that we can put forward all the activities which are being taken up by the previous governments, by last government, in a different format, and how Make in India and how lot many other activities can be performed in a wonderful way. So my appeal to all the young people, to all the members, to try to find out, there are so many ways, so many initiatives which are being taken by the government of India. But the point is how we are going through the same, whether we are able to have awareness about all the programs, all the initiatives, all the policies, all the strategies, whatever the initiatives being taken by the government of India. So my point is, whether we are doing it, any of the degree, any of the graduation or the post-graduation, maybe the technical degree or maybe the management degree or any of the degree. But what is going in the country? What are the different schemes being launched under the Narega, Manrega, or Ujwala, this and that? There are so many initiatives with regard to the employment generating activities as well as for the entrepreneurial activities. And I think we can have awareness of all those activities being initiatives taken by in different formats, by Niti Aayog, by MSMEs, by a number of other formulations of policies and programs by Government of India. So we must take initiative for the same. And on this occasion, I will not take much of your time. Reason being, we are awaiting the beautiful time point to be recited by Manya and documentary to be prepared by our BCA students. And I again compliment and congratulate all of you on the occasion of 75th Independence Day of the country. And we wish all will progress in such a direction that we will have a beautiful era ahead and the beautiful time ahead. Thank you so much. And once again, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Jai Hind.
Hello everyone, my name is Manya Vadera and I'm from Apeejay College of Management and Engineering Technical Campus. And today, on this very special occasion of Independence Day, I'm here to recite a poem before you, which is written by me, Ishq-e Watan. Gun-gunaye jo garz, tu fakr, tu hi mera hai harz. Eh watan, tu hi jaan, hue jaan saar, tu kya hai harz? Kalam se ya kamaan se, garv is mitti mahan pe. है आशिकी वतन से यही मोहब्बत है जुबान पे है रक्त से लिखी गई जो गाथाएं महान है कुर्बानियों की महक कविताओं से बयान है रंगीन है जो जिंदगी यहाँ तिरंगे तुझ पे ही गुमान है तू गर्व से लहरा रहा तू ही दशकों सी शान है ना जात से ना धर्म से तुझसे मिले आयाम है जो शान से जय भारत कहे काबिल वही जुबान है बसता है रूम में देश जो दुनिया पे तू ही छाएगा जुबान से जो शोर उठा जय हिंद जय हिंद जय हिंद ही सुना जाएगा धन्यवाद
जय हिंद
थैंक यू सो मच मान्या
On the eve of Independence Day, we had organized two activities. One activity was related to food presentation. The rule of the event were only one participant was allowed to participate. He was allowed to use any kind of food. Earlier we were thinking on the line that we should have a salad presentation for this, but then we allowed to have a bite scope for the same. We allowed raw and cooked food as well. So the color representation was allowed, tricolor, especially the colors of the flag. Okay. So a number of students participated in the same. I would like to share with you the different contributions. So the first entry by Ravneet of MBA 2A, she shared a 30-second video for preparing the same. So here is the product. The next entry in this context was by Damini Prasher of MBA 2B. She tried to present through pulses and she shared two entries in the same. Then we had one more entry from Simran Jyot of PTEC 5. So we had one more entry from Kashish. These are the entries which got shortlisted out of many. Some of them maybe got rejected for certain reasons because they were not as per the criteria. Was the product by Kashish of MBA 2A. Very beautifully presented the things as per the theme. Next, we had more presentations by Manoj of MBA 2B. We had one more entry from Gia of BBA second semester. One more entry. The number of students participated is really happy for the students. They worked hard. So the competition was really tough. It was even really challenging for the judges to decide about the winners. Finally, we have the list of winners with us. Going to share with the winners for the first event named Tricolor Food Presentation. The third prize in this list is won by team T1, and the second prize goes to team with tag T3, and the first prize goes to team with tag T4. Then going with the next event in the series, online quiz. It was the quiz dedicated to the Tokyo Olympic winners, India's participation, especially dedicated to the winners of Tokyo Olympics. So it was made live to the students on Google. Okay, so it was live from 14th of August to 15th of August. Okay, so it was live for 2 days. Number of students participated, it was a timed quiz. Okay, so time allowed was 10 minutes, 20 questions were there. Some of the people were not able to solve the same in 20 minutes, 10 minutes. So they were disqualified. Among the list of the shortlisted, the top 30, which we shortlisted, then the winners for the quiz are, or especially I would like to share the different teams which participated in the quiz. We had students from 10 plus 2 segment, other segment, MC, MBA, BCom, BBA, almost all the branches or courses participated in the same. So the first prize in this category goes to Sejal Arora, who is a student of BTech Semester 3. She got 20 out of 20, I would be happy to share. And for the second and third prize, there was a tie actually. So because Saurav of BCA Semester 5, won the second prize, reason being he took less time as compared to the third prize in this category, which goes to Kanksha. She took a relatively, you can say, few seconds more to win the title. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Tokyo 2020. I won 7 medals at Tokyo, 1 gold, 2 silver, and 4 bronze. It's biggest Olympic haul ever. And India has now reached 48th rank the Tokyo Olympics. Now, I would like to invite students of class BCA5 to present their documentary.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
Gurmanu Vargai.
Congratulations to all the winners. Now, we'd like to present the documentary.
India ended 2020 Tokyo campaign in the best way possible by winning a gold medal courtesy Neeraj Chopra. With that goal, India's medal tally has reached 7, the highest ever, the world's biggest sporting event.
The most successful Olympics for India. With 7 medals, Tokyo 2020, the previous high of 6 at the London Olympics in 2012. India started their campaign with a bang. Weightlifter Mirabai Chanu lifting 1.3 billion to Olympic glory on the first day itself. A medal favorite, Chanu ended India's over 2-decade long wait for a weightlifting medal. Joining Mirabai on the podium with another silver medal was wrestler Ravi Dahia, who had an exceptional run-up until the final. With Dahia's medal, India also continued their run of winning a wrestling medal at every Olympics since Sushil Kumar won it in 2008. PV Sindhu, India's badminton queen, was phenomenal in women's singles. Adding to her silver from Rio 5 years back, Sindhu won the bronze at Tokyo to become India's most successful female Olympian. Lovlina Borgohai, the boxer from Assam, punched well above her weight in the women's welterweight event. Lovlina's quarterfinal victory against former world champion Chen Ninchen will go down as one of the best bouts by an Indian boxer at the Olympics. She finished with a bronze after losing to the eventual gold medalist Buzinaz Surminelli. There were some big disappointments too. A lot of India's medal hopes were built around the aura of the world number ones in the shooting contingent. Three shooters, barring Saurabh Chaudhary, did not even qualify for the final events, let alone the podium. Much touted names like Manu Bhakkar, Divyansh Singh Pawar, Apurvi Chandela and others seemed overwhelmed by the occasion. And as a result, India ended up with 0 medals in shooting. The story of the archers was no different. They showed glimpses of magic but missed arrows as well as medals. But amid the disappointment, our hockey teams turned a new chapter at Tokyo Olympics. While the women showed grit and determination to even reach the knockouts, their victory against Australia in the quarters will be remembered for years to come. From the wooden spoon in Rio, India finished 4th in Tokyo and narrowly missed out on a medal. In men's hockey, Manpreet and his team smashed their 41-year-old Olympic jinx and defeated Germany 5-4 to win India their first medal since the gold in Moscow 1980. By the end of the tournament, India had reminded the world of why they are the most successful hockey team in Olympic history. And even though it wasn't gold, it was a reminder of how good they can be. And on India's final day at the Olympics, Bajrang Punia won the country another bronze. He put the disappointment of his semi-final loss behind and put on a flawless performance to win India another medal. But India's crowning moment came right at the very end. In India's final event at Tokyo 2020, Neeraj Chopra, the man from Haryana, won their first ever track and field gold in the country's history. For a nation that had waited for this glory for so long, Chopra provided the perfect end to the games for India. His phenomenal show in javelin throw will go down in history as one of India's biggest and brightest moment at the world's biggest stage. And with 7 medals to show for, Tokyo 2020 will go down as India's best ever Olympics. Hopefully, that will change with Paris 2024.
So I think big round of applause for all the medal winners along with all the members of country. They participated, those participated in Tokyo 2020. And really we should appreciate, and I think we are feeling proud of all these players who have given their participation in Tokyo.
गलियों में राशन की फलियों में बैलों में बीजों में ईदों में बीजों में रेतों के दानों में फिल्मों के गानों में सड़कों के गड्ढों में बातों के अड्डों में हुंकार राज भर ले दस बार बार कर ले रहना न यार पीछे कितना भी कोई खींचे
For India and for BCF5 for preparing such a beautiful documentary.
So my apologies for a few technical glitches today, but I think on the other hand, we must appreciate all the efforts being made by all of our students and faculty as well. A beautiful prayer by Pahul Preet and beautiful poem being recited by Manya, and then further a wonderful documentary being prepared by all of our BCA students. We must appreciate the efforts of all of our students with big round of applause. Wonderful. So I think Daljeet, now national anthem. So I think we will all stand up for the national anthem.
Jana Gana Mana Adhinayaka Jaya Hind Bharat Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गा जयदाता जनगण मंगलदायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे